the children you're bringing up, whether they're coming as babies or older children, they've had so much damage done to them throughout their lives.
Jacqueline has been a foster carer for 10 years, looking after some of Scotland's most vulnerable kids. She'll benefit from the new minimum allowance to help her care for them. It's something she has campaigned for with the IWGB Foster Care Workers Union.
You're just constantly putting your own money into it. Every single penny that comes into the house is going into raising these kids because you don't want them to go without anything.
Announced last week, this brings Scotland in line with the rest of the UK in offering a basic rate to carers employed by local authorities. The flat fee will apply to all council areas. The new rates mean an average increase of £29 a week for foster carers of younger children. Increases for older children vary depending on age. Jacqueline, though, is still left £35 worse off in real terms than 10 years ago.
The only way the government is ever going to solve that is, first of all, giving us the amount that it actually costs us to raise these children.
Local authorities set their own allowances, so they're different across Scotland. For carers with Glasgow City Council, the last increase for all rates was 10 years ago.
We do want people to become foster carers, and I absolutely appreciate that some people have had a really difficult experience, but others have had an amazing experience.
The Fostering Network in Scotland welcomes the new minimum, but says it doesn't go far enough.
As an organisation, we want to ensure that those allowances rise in line with inflation, particularly during this very difficult time when we have a cost of living crisis and we know that the cost of raising a child is increasing.
Inflation is a worry with no guarantee that these new allowances will rise year on year. But there's something else at play here too, and it's consistency in how foster carers are paid.
The new minimum allowance means local authority carers get the same no matter where they live. But if you work for an independent fostering agency, you will receive a different financial support package, often at a higher rate. It's all money that comes from the same local authority budgets.
Money that's paid to fostering agencies, be they local authority services or independent providers, is from the same pot of money in order to care for those children and young people.
In a statement, the Scottish Government says they work closely with local authorities and will continue to work collaboratively with all partners in their journey to keep the promise by 2030.
If we didn't do it, who would do it? That's the only reason I know any foster carer I know just does it for the kids. They just love the kids that they have, you know. It probably could get to a stage that it will become impossible for people to do, to actually manage a household and still manage to foster. Although we're almost there, we're not quite there yet, and as long as we have the kids that we've got in our care, we'll carry on doing it. £400 per child after...
A warning that for some, fostering is becoming harder, not easier. Anton Ferrie, BBC News.